Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be going over my favorite new features in Lumion 9. All right, so you may remember this 3D model. There's a speed model of this. And one of the things I was struggling with is that it's a snow scene. And so one of the things that I had to do was I had to find these trees that don't have any foliage, because I couldn't find any good ones that don't look dead in Lumion. So I imported those. That's fine. That's whatever. But the other thing that I was having trouble with was with snow. You could add snow in Lumion 8.5, but what happened to me is that I would add snow and then the entire interior would also be coated with snow. So now in Lumion 9, when I go to effects, go to weather and climate, there's this precipitation tab. Now there's rain or snow, but you can see here, you can change the block bias. But basically, now you can see a little bit. If I zoom in, if you go really high, you can see that snow starts to go inside, but you now have a slider that you can avoid that. So it seems very cool. Really enjoy that. The only thing, I'm not 100% sure if I like the way that it's doing the trees. I think it would be really nice if there was some like wind options, because block by plants would be great, but because this is actually like a model that I had to bring in because I didn't like the trees, and unfortunately, although they did claim to add new vegetation, deciduous trees without foliage is not an option, so womp. But basically, I love this feature though. You can obviously change it to rain as well. But yeah, it's a great new feature for adding snow. The other thing that I really, really enjoy is that they added real skies. So it seems like all of these skies are from Polygon, but now you can add a sky. So let's say like overcast might be a good one because it's a snowy day. So I just click that and it adds in the sky. You can reverse it. You can change the location of it, but it also affects the lighting. So very cool. I love that feature. In terms of new models, I know that they boasted a ton of new content. I think that number is probably a little misleading. I think they said over 5,000 models, but I don't think that's necessarily new models. I think that was including all the old models. I haven't noticed a lot of new things. I know that they boasted the cars, but it doesn't seem like there's a whole lot more cars in here, but I could be wrong. I don't use cars very often. One thing that I did notice is that there are some more people, a few more people. I know that I don't think I had people riding a bike, or at least as many people. So I think that's a little bit different. I did notice that there is a much larger library in Kitchen for doing any sort of cabinetry. I think before I had to import everything, but you can see all the different cooktops that they have here, and then all of the cabinetry. Let me get there. A ton of different options for cabinetry. You can sort of, now you can essentially play Legos with these. There's different styles, and that's really exciting, because in this model, which has a little kitchen on this side, I had to build my own. So very cool new models. I love it. Here I have imported a SketchUp 3D model of a building, and the landscape is also generated in SketchUp. The only thing that is in Lumion currently, or that was generated in Lumion, is the plants. So that's all in Lumion. And this next feature is possibly my favorite. So once you have a landscape in here, if you have modeled that in 3D, you can apply a material to it. The material is currently coming directly from SketchUp. So if I mouse over, you can see it's called vegetation grass. If I just click it, there's now this option in nature. There's 2D grass, and now there's 3D grass. So if I click 3D grass, you can see there are a bunch of different options in here. Now, I always feel like I struggle with making grass in any 3D software that I've done. It just takes a long time to render if you're doing it in something like V-Ray, because you have to essentially add fur or bump maps or things like that to to fake it. And so in Lumion, it's been really nice because they've been able to add like huge clusters of grass to make it more realistic. But with this new 3D grass tool, it's even easier than it was before. So now you can just essentially just click one of these, and there's a bunch of different options. There's a checkerboard, there's some more checkerboards, circular grass. If you like those sort of like stripes, you can do that. Farm grass, which gives these little like horizontal rows, clean cut. I personally always sort of like the wild looking grass. That's probably a little too wild for me. This looks okay. But additionally to that, if you double click it, you can see there's a ton of different options in here. So you can even customize it even more. So there's gravity force, which you can see just makes it go a little bit. And then there's this bending force. You can see either you want it to like spread out. It's kind of like what it looks like it's doing. So you may just want to mess with this stuff. Grass size, grass length, you can do that. And someone asked me a question earlier this week about colorization of grass, and I said you could do it in with the old feature of 8.5, you could change the color, but in 9 it's even easier. So if you just want to bump up the colorization to be max, you just go to RGB and you can change it to any color you want. So if I wanted it to be pink, for whatever reason, I could do that. So really love that feature. I'm just gonna exit out of this really quick and then just pick the default, one of the defaults here, 3D grass. We just keep it on this. Really love this feature, and I think it just adds so much to 3D modeling, and you don't have to spend so much time. So I just love this. And let me just hit the render button and you guys can see what the finished product here would look like. We talked about this a little bit earlier, but one thing that is new in Lumion 9 is precipitation. And I showed you snow, but there's actually also rain. So if you add effect, go to weather, climate, precipitation, you can add rain as well. And so I sort of have that, you can see the rain here, but if I go here, you can see there's actually little raindrops, which is pretty cool. So if I play this, you can see that there's these little animations that come up from the rain, which I think adds a lot of atmosphere. And you can also change the amount that the ground is wet, which is very cool. So if I go to precipitation, you can change the phase here. So if it's just starting, you know, to being soaked, and you get that line here from the roof, which is very cool. Another one of the really cool features in Lumion 9 that is sort of similar to grass is that you can now add fur. So if I have the material editor selected and I select this blanket, which I've named fur, you can go to nature, and under nature there is now an option called fur, and you can select any of these presets or double click and you get a lot more color options in here. So if you want it to be a little bit more rough, you can certainly do that. Colorization I always sort of like. I want this to be a darker red though. And you can always just, this might be a little much. But you can really mess with the character of this fur blanket, and it gives a really unique quality to your materials. In Lumion 9, they also changed the user interface. So you can see here that it's a little bit more opaque, whereas in 7 or 8.5, the menu is very transparent or translucent. And they also added this feature when you're placing. So before they had single placement, they also had mass placement. Now there's this new option called cluster placement. So if I have this tree, you can see there's a bunch of those little boxes. It'll just place a small cluster of trees, which is, I think, really cool. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this video, please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe. And as always, happy hacking.